defense. How about the Sugar Bowl? Utah spread offense is led by an outstanding athlete at quarterback, Brian Johnson, throwing a touchdown pass in 13 straight games. Now, on the other side of the ball, Alabama's offense features the run. They've scored 32 touchdowns on the ground compared to 4 by the opponents. That's a good-looking football team that tied.
Down in the Superdome, Alabama's last visit to the Sugar Bowl was the capper to that 1992 national championship season. 93, they took on Miami. And the U rolled in with 29 straight victories. But what an awful night for Gino Toretta. Picked off by George Teague. He takes it to the house. True. Alabama didn't do much on offense.
Oh, no.
Dominated defense. Play. Lamar Thomas, look out, Lamar.
Watch out.
Trouble. Oi. Jay Barker completes 4 passes. Beam Stallings gets a bath. Alabama wins the national championship and they take on Utah. Mm-hmm. First time there since that big win. Happy New Year to Desmond Howard.
Yeah, Happy New Year, fellas.
This is a great place. I love this place.
Young freshman.
Oh, yeah.
Wolverines come out here.
Exactly.
Beats USC.
Yeah, no, that was a big win for us. Leroy Horde got the MVP
of
the game.
I remember that. Yeah, loses the next year.
Exactly. We lost.
2 years later on the program, blown out by Washington. To me, we give
blood. Down to history, huh?
Yeah, I'm just saying, huh? We praise. It's all part of your charm. We love you.
Nothing's off limits here.
He had a big game down in the Superdome, MVP of the Super Bowl 31, right?
We're going through your whole career here, kid.
Because we segue to the Superdome.
Okay, there you go.
Utah,
you go.
Right. Takes on Alabama as a non-BCS automatic qualifying conference. The fourth time, of course, they just took Pittsburgh to the woodshed a few years ago, 35-7 in the 05 Fiesta Bowl to complete that perfect season, the last game there for Urban Meyer. In goes Utah to that same venue as the last of the unbeatens, a significant underdog and kind of a de facto road game in the Superdome against the SEC, a conference they haven't played since 1984, and a conference they've never beaten. They are 0-6. But they do have the nation's longest bowl winning streak with the loss yesterday at BC. They won 7 in a row and a chance to become the first program in the BCS era to have a pair of perfect seasons. Can they handle the tide up front? Oh, that's the issue there. Alabama is physical. They're tough. They have the running game. And even without the loss of arguably their best player, Andre Smith, the left tackle, the junior sent home because he had improper contact with an agent, not an NCAA issue, but it's a team violation and a family matter, according to Nick Saban. So the guy they called the franchise won't be able to help. Saban, not a lot to say about it this week.
I'm not giving you the details of it, and I'm not talking about it. You know, Andre Smith is a fine young man, and he did a great job here for us. He may be doing a great job for somebody else in the future. He may be doing a great job for us some more. That decision has not been made. His family has represented, he's represented this university as well as his family in a fine fashion, and we're pleased and with what he's done to help our team be successful.
That's a bummer. Obviously, he's a very, very highly rated draft prospect. His junior made that error in judgment, as Saban said. Here's a big reason why they have 32 rushing touchdowns. Mike Johnson, left guard, shifts over to tackle to take his place. And he's experienced there. They doesn't figure to be, you know, a huge drop-off. What do the Utes, you know, have to do? How can they hang with this team?
Well, the first thing that jumps out of my mind, Chris, and I think about this matchup, if they want to really play with Bama, the quarterback, Brian Johnson, must be protected. Now, if he's allowed to be productive and move that offense at a fast tempo, then it can pay big dividends later in the game, just like it did for the Florida Gators in the SEC Championship. The second thing, that defense must find a way to exploit the absence of Andre Smith, the best left tackle, the best offensive alignment in the game. Now they're going to move a guard over, but still, he hasn't played left tackle. That's a very important position, especially for a right-handed quarterback. Kirk in this game, I expect to see a lot of stunts and blitzes coming from that left tackle area.
Yeah, there's no question. They're going to try to affect the continuity of Alabama up front in the offensive line. I think this game really just comes down to, does Alabama show up ready to go? Are they motivated after a disappointing loss in the SEC Championship to go into this football game and go out with a win and to have a great feel for the 2008 season? Because this Utah team is not Hawaii. They're blue collar. Their coach Kyle Whittingham knows how to get his team ready. They'll play with a chip on their shoulder. Brian Johnson, the quarterback that Des just talked about, is a steady hand, a veteran who runs an offense that he's very familiar with. 9 touchdown passes in the last 2 games, Lee.
Yep.
I think Utah can hang around.
Yep.
But ultimately, the home field advantage and Nick Saban getting his team ready, I think the Crimson Tide get it done.
But one thing about him, you know, Utah's a very confident football team. Mm-hmm. Why? Well, they won 20 out of the last 21, 13 in a row. They got a shot at this upset if they don't get blown out in the first half. The Tide beats the opponents 244-64 in the first half. I think they do. I think this game will be much closer than the experts think. I think the Tide win it in the fourth quarter, but Utah gives them all they can handle. It's a nice-looking football team, well-coached.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. If Whittingham pulls the upset,
well-coached.
I mean, he becomes one of the hot names in coaching. Mm-hmm. He's still kind of an undervalued guy, even though their team is.
Yeah. Just got an
12-0
extension.
Coming in. He did, but I think nationally, there's not the perception
No.
This guy is an elite coach. So much closer than Georgia Hawaii last year when you picked
that was
Rainbow.
It's a different deal.
It's a different deal.
My friend said it. This is not a Hawaii.
This is not a Hawaii.
Thank you for mentioning that.
Good point.
I agree. I thought he was building another upset pick.
Oh, yeah.
Not so fast, my friend. Not so
fast. SEC in that building. Tough to beat.
All right, that was quick.
Watch this. I'm going to bring it quick.
Sugar Bowl, Utah and Alabama tomorrow night. Fox has it.
Hey, Utah comes out and plays real close, but they lose at the end. Alabama close.
Alabama,
game.
Glenn Coffey, Mark Ingram, powerful running game, keeps the ball away from Brian Johnson.
You can't stay close. You can't stay close.
Down in front of me, reminds me of where I wanna be.
End zone ahead, folks.
If you want your love, pull me in like you were made for me. I'm losing faith in gravity.
Are you kidding me?
And I just need to let you know.
Never seen any player in the entire country play as hard as I will play the rest of the season.
You teach me to run.